Hi guys, welcome to another audio video, and I'll be reading Exodus 32 of the King James Version Bible. And it reads, "And when the people saw that Moses delayed to come down out of the mount, the people gathered themselves together unto Aaron, and said unto him, Up, make us gods, which shall go before us. For as for this Moses, the man that brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we wot not what is become of him. And Aaron said unto them, Break off the golden earrings which are in the ears of your wives, of your sons, and of your daughters, and bring them unto me. And all the people brake the golden earrings which were in their ears, and brought them unto Aaron. And he received them at their hand, and fashioned it into a graven tool, after he had made it a molten calf. As they said, These be thy gods. O Israel, which brought thee up out of the land of Egypt. And when Aaron saw it, he built an altar before it, and Aaron made proclamation, and said, Tomorrow is a feast to the Lord. And they rose up early on the morrow, and offered burnt offerings, and brought peace offerings, and the people sat down to eat and to drink, and rose up to play. And the Lord said unto Moses, Go, get thee down, for thy people, which thou broughtest out of the land of Egypt, have corrupted themselves. They have turned aside quickly out of the way which I commanded them. They have made them a molten calf, and have worshipped it, and have sacrificed thereunto, and said, These be thy gods, O Israel, which have brought thee up out of the land of Egypt. And the Lord said unto Moses, I have seen this people, and behold, it is a stiff-necked people. Now, therefore, let me alone, that my wrath may wax hot against them, and that I may consume them, and I will make of thee a great nation. And Moses besought the Lord his God, and said, Lord, why doth thy wrath wax hot against thy people, which thou hast brought forth out of the land of Egypt with great power and with a mighty hand? Wherefore should the Egyptians speak and say, For mischief did he bring them out, to slay them in the mountains, and to consume them from the face of the earth? Turn from thy fierce wrath, and repent of this evil against thy people. Remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel thy servants, to whom thou swearest by thine own self, and saidest unto them, I will multiply your seed as the stars of heaven, and all this land that I have spoken of will I give unto your seed, and they shall inherit it forever. And the Lord repented of the evil which he thought to do unto his people. And Moses turned and went down from the mount, and the two tables of the testimony were in his hand. The tables were written on both their sides, on the one side and on the other were they written. And the tables were the work of God, and the writing was the writing of God graven upon the tables. And when Joshua heard the noise of the people as they shouted, he said unto Moses, There is a noise of war in the camp. And he said, It is not the voice of them that shout for mastery, neither is it the voice of them that cry for being overcome, but the noise of them that sing do I hear. And it came to pass, as soon as he came nigh upon the camp, that he saw the calf and the dancing, and Moses' anger waxed hot, and he cast the tables out of his hand, and brake them beneath the mount. And he took the calf which they had made, and burnt it in the fire, and ground it to powder, and strawed it upon the water, and made the children of Israel drink of it. And Moses said unto Aaron, What did this people unto thee, that thou hast brought so great a sin upon them? And Aaron said, Let not the anger of my Lord wax hot. Thou knowest the people, that they are set on mischief. For they said unto me, Make us gods, which shall go before us. For as for this Moses, the man that brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we wot not what is become of him. And I said unto them, whoever hath any gold, let them break it off. So they gave it me. Then I cast it into the fire, and there came out this calf. And when Moses saw that the people were naked, for Aaron had made them naked unto their shame among their enemies, then Moses stood in the gate of the camp and said, who is on the Lord's side? Let him come unto me. And all the sons of Levi gathered themselves together unto him. And he said unto them, thus saith the Lord God of Israel, put every man his sword in his side, and go in and out from gate to gate throughout the camp, and slay every man his brother, and every man his companion, and every man his neighbor. And the children of Levi did according to the word of Moses, and there fell off the people that day about 3,000 men. For Moses has said, consecrate yourselves today to the Lord, even every man upon his son and upon his brother, that he may bestow upon you a blessing this day. And it came to pass on the morrow that Moses said unto the people, ye have sinned a great sin, and now I will go up unto the Lord. Peradventure I shall make an atonement for your sin. And Moses returned unto the Lord and said, oh, this people have sinned a great sin, and have made them gods of gold. Yet now, if thou wilt forgive their sin, and if not, blot me, I pray thee, out of thy book which thou hast written. And the Lord said unto Moses, whosoever hath sinned against me, him will I blot out of my book. Therefore now go, lead the people unto the place of which I have spoken unto thee. Behold, mine angel shall go before thee. Nevertheless, in the day when I will visit their sin upon them. And the Lord plagued the people because they made the calf which Aaron made. All right, so here we see that the children of Israel turned out to be very, very disobedient. And they actually turned their backs on God, actually. One of the commandments that they vowed themselves, each of them as an individual, the covenant that they made with God, saying that they'd keep the commandments that Moses had brought down from Mount Sinai unto them from God. And they made vows themselves. It is not a covenant any longer with Israel or with Isaac or with Abraham. It is a covenant in and of itself between them and God, each individual and God, and they broke it. And so God is visiting them, and God decided that, okay, he is going to cause a plague to set upon the people. And that's exactly what he has done here. That is said in the last verse 35. All right, and so this goes to show you that whenever you make a vow unto God, or whenever you enter into a covenant with God, you should keep it and do not anger God, unless your sin will actually come back at you because you have sinned against him. So brothers and sisters, non-Christians, I'm encouraging you to keep your words, not only the words that you vow to God, but also your words that you vow to each other. And so you should not go into making promises lightly. You should not take promises lightly or vows lightly. You should keep them. And if you know that you won't be of the capacity to keep them, or you doubt that you'll be able to keep them, then don't go ahead and make them. Marriage vows is one such vow. If you know you're not of the capacity or the state of mind to actually be loyal and carry out all the vows that you say on your wedding day before God and man, then do not go ahead. Remain by yourself. Remain untouched. Remain single, if so be it. But do not make a vow that you know you cannot keep. Because It will indeed visit you, and if it does not visit you, it will visit your generations after you. That sin will actually visit them. And so, guys, those are my few words to you. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification so you're alerted to whenever a new audio video is posted. And guys, I'm looking forward to hearing your feedback, your comments, and your thoughts down in the comment section below. Okay, guys, have yourselves a blessed day. Bye.